Hey everyone, and welcome back to another Unreal Tips and Tricks series. In today's episode, we will show you how to play a car door opening close sequence in a few simple steps using the sequencer tool and a hotkey input to trigger the animation via a blueprint system. Alright, let's get started and check the structure of our car. I imported the model using Datasmith. We can see that Datasmith did a good job importing the components respecting the child parent linking. Let's take a closer look at the door underscore passenger. We can see that the components are a child of door underscore passenger. That meaning that all of the door parts are attached to that actor. Now, if I press G on my keyboard to show the actors, and select that specific actor called door underscore passenger, I can start rotating it and see that all of the door components rotate also, which is exactly what we want for our animation. Our next step is to record that rotation animation, and for this case, we'll use the sequencer tool. Let's go to our cinematics button on the toolbar and let's click on add level sequence. Let's name this door underscore open. Press enter and this will open a new sequencer tab for you. Let's make sure that we set the loop to not loop and that the pause at end is enabled. Now with that created, let's select our actor in the viewport. So let me enable the actors by pressing G on the keyboard. Let's grab the actor, so door underscore passenger in my case. And let's go to our sequencer tab, right click, actor to sequencer, and add door passenger. So what we want to do here is track the transform properties. So I'm going to go in on the plus sign here, track, and let's enable the transforms. Let's expand the properties and we can see here that we have location, rotation, and scale. So we're going to be looking at the rotation here. We can already set a keyframe for the default state at frame 0. So I'm going to go ahead and press plus here. Now, I like to use the auto keyframer. So if you press on this button here, this is going to enable the keyframer. And let's jump to frame 90. And let's make sure that we have the angle snap turned on. So I'm going to enable it again and change my degrees to 5 degrees to have a bit more precision. Let's press E on the keyboard and let's start capturing that property. So I'm going to make my door open 40 degrees. Now, as soon as I let go of my mouse, this creates a keyframe for me. So if I scrub through the animation, we can see that the door is opening and closing correctly. So let's make sure that we set the default 150 end range to now 90. Now that the sequence is done, let's jump into the blueprints and trigger the animation with a hotkey. So let's jump into our content browser and right click. And let's create a blueprint class, and this is going to be an actor. So I'm going to name mine BP underscore door animation. So once that is created, let's go into the event graph. And for the sake of the tutorial here, I'm going to be using the event begin play. So I'm going to delete these two nodes. And the first thing that we want to do is make sure that the input is enabled. So I'm going to go in the event begin play from the node and type in enable inputs. And the second thing that we want to do is get the player controller. And this is going to ensure that the input is correctly detected. Now, the second thing that we want to do is get all actors of class and specify that we want to get the level sequence class. So I'm going to drag a node and type in get all actors of class. And this is the one I'm going to be using. And in the actors class, I'm going to be specifying that we are going to be using the level sequence actor. So out of that array, we want to get a copy. So I'm going to type in get copy. And from that copy, we're going to promote a variable. So I'm going to right click right on that blue node and promote a variable. And this has created a new variable for me. So I'm going to just name it something a bit more adequate, like door anim. And we can see that the variable type is corresponding to the level sequence, which is what we want. So I'm going to drag that node and make sure that it's correctly set up. So the second thing that we want to do here is enable a key input. So I'm going to be using my keyboard, but you can use a controller if you want. So I'm going to right click here and I'm going to be using the O key on my keyboard. So I'm going to type in O keyboard and that's going to bring me that input. And I want to be using the same input for opening and closing. So what I'm going to do here is use a flip-flop node. And basically what we're going to do here is say that A is going to play the animation and B is going to reverse the animation. So before we do that, let's grab our door animation variable that we created and let's get the door anim variable. And we're simply going to type in here, play sequence. And so this guy here, we can get the play sequence. And I'm going to drag another node, but this time I'm going to do play reverse sequence. And all I have to do here is plug A to the play sequence and B to the play reverse. Now, once that is done, let's compile and save. So once in our scene, let's make sure to drag the blueprint actor into the viewport and let's go into our play mode and test this out. So I'm here in the scene and I'm going to play, press on the O keyboard inputs and we can see that it's correctly opening the door. Now, if I press the same key again, it's going to reverse the animation. I hope you enjoyed this video and hope to see you very soon in the next Unreal Tips and Tricks series.